Hi, this is Daz from Thailand Wild with the first part of a two-day trip to Tong Pa Phum National Park in Kanchanaburi Province on the west of Thailand. To start the evening, we've come into the garden of an old friend who used to live here. In the past, we found Ganbury pit vipers occasionally in his garden. We didn't find any this evening, but we did find this frog. I think this is a dark-sided frog. This beautiful little lizard is an Oldham's bent-toed gecko. Very exciting for me. I saw one for the first time when I was here in Tong Pa Phum a few weeks ago, and now I actually have the chance to film one. Look at that. A lovely feature of the gecko is able to clean their eyes with their tongue. Well, we didn't find the Ganbury pit viper earlier, but this was another of our target species here. This is a white-lipped pit viper. We found these before around Tong Pa Phum and lower down in the national park. And we particularly wanted to get some film of it because tomorrow we're going to go to a higher altitude and see if we can find Pope's pit viper, which is often found higher up in the hills than these white-lipped pit vipers.
I'm sure there could have been, there could be funnier ones. I think I've seen funnier ones with dogs and cats and stuff online, but yeah, it would be pretty funny actually. And I wouldn't be too worried about being bitten by one this size. Actually, this is about the size, but a little bit smaller than the one that you're biting, I think. Yeah, that tail, that ant is still on there, though.
Yeah, I'm going to remove that ant.
Yeah, you can really see that, the difference with the eye there. It's just, right. Rather than the big eye looking like a big-eyed one to me now, these ones just look like they've got a little piggy eye by comparison. Oh. Yeah. Crashed the shot.
Well, this viper has got an ant clamped to its tail, and Alex is determined to remove it.
Oh, come on, relax. Okay.
You got it?
Yeah.
Nice job.
Okay. That way. That's the way you were going.
Off you go. Off you go.
No,
to
the side.
It's all
right
now.
No. That way. Off you go. Yay! Follow the chevrons.
We often find the molted skins of insects hanging on leaves in the morning and think to ourselves, I wish I'd seen that happening. Well, if you want to see it happening, nighttime is the right time. And this is a Bengal slow loris. Most of the times when I've seen them before, it has just been eye shine from distant trees, but we can actually get a reasonable view of the animal here. This was one of many that we saw on this first night up in Tong Pa Phum National Park. Wonderful.
Yep, right there. Real slow. Just coming out of that last bit of greenery on the other side.
Right. Yep.
Amazingly, slow lorises have a toxic bite, something which is unique among primates and very rare in mammals, in fact.
Oh, it's going to go up the other bamboo by the looks of things.
I'm gonna go up there. I'm gonna run down and test the venom theory.
No, I want to film you doing that. Not heading on down to the female, is it? That would be something if this thing actually attempted to mate. It's got a long way to go though, isn't it?
Well, believe it or not, this is the male of the giant wood spider or northern golden orb weaver, and here is the female. Look how large she is in comparison. You can compare against the strands of the web to how diminutive the male was that we saw just now. And this gorgeous, large cicada species, we believe, is Megapomponia intermedia, previously known as Pomponia, but several of the larger species have been split out into a new genus of their own now. This one was attracted by our lights and crashed into us several times.
Oh, it looks like you actually cleaned your nails for once. Put them in the picture here. They're looking good.
I try.
And look at this. Just resting up on the side of the road. And I was able to get very, very close to it. A male large-tailed nightjar. Absolutely fantastic. I'm so close to this bird. I can't believe it's not flying away. But apparently this is what they do. We found a nice area of water along the side of the road that goes up through the park here, and there are quite a few of these frogs in it. These have been identified as Gerogene's stream frog. I'm really delighted to see that name, named in honor, presumably, of one of Thailand's great scientists, Ajahn Gerogene. I haven't got a name for this crab, but I don't suppose it cares too much about that. Well, Alex has just called me down the road to film a lizard which was sleeping up on the bushes, but before I could even get there, he's found a green cat snake. My goodness, we are having a fantastic night here. What an absolute beauty this is. I love the grey eyes on this species. The first time I ever saw one, it was very high up in a tree, but I was able to get a pair of binoculars on it, and when I saw that eye, there was no doubt about what species it was. As you know, if you've seen some of the other clips, we don't generally like to handle snakes very much. And as this one was just moving slowly and doing its own thing, I prefer to try to get film of that when I can. And here is the lizard, the garden crested lizard that I was actually on my way to film, very close to where the snake was just a moment ago. A lot of spiders here in the park, very easy to see them at night, but just not easy to identify, and unfortunately I don't have a name for this one. There are a lot of tarantulas here in Tompaapum National Park, and this one has been identified as a cobalt blue tarantula. What a gorgeous name. You can often see the burrows of these ones along the side of the road that goes up through the park. And then another beautiful spider that I was able to get very close to. This one has been ID'd as a Heteropoda tetrica. Well, that's it for part one of our trip to Tom Papum National Park. I'll upload the second part next week.